This is a guide to install LineageOS, an unofficial version of LineageOS, onto this, the Walmart ON or ONN UHD streaming device. So holidays right now, and so you can pick it up for about $20, which is super, super cheap for a 4K streaming device. So this guide is on how to set up that unofficial version of LineageOS onto this box. Going to remove the existing Android TV and replace it with the custom ROM. Now, just a couple points before we get started on this. One is use at your own risk. You've been warned. Not my responsibility if your device gets bricked. Be sure to look at the instructions and look at the links that are below wherever you're watching this video or on my blog, obscurednarration.com, to keep up with whatever changes have happened since this video has been made. Things change all the time. There could be an update that comes out for the box, and this process doesn't work anymore. So be sure to do your homework and verify that. This is also going to void your warranty. So if you brick it and you want to return it, that's on you. The last thing is that this is for this specific device. This little tiny one, this ON or ONN UHD device. It's for this particular one. There are other devices that this unofficial Lineage port works on. You'll have to look at the notes, but make sure that you have this exact one and it's matched up exactly to the exact same device. If you try to flash the wrong version of the ROM onto it, it's going to brick it and your warranty is void. I felt that $20 was worth the price of admission to be able to play around with it. So this little box is fun. It has a HDMI out and then a micro USB port. And next to the on light is a single button. So that's everything that it is, that this whole device is. My setup for going in and adjusting this and installing a custom recovery and then a custom ROM is I just use a regular micro USB cable plugged into my computer. And then I like to use just one of these cheap HDMI capture cards. That way I can use OBS and then put that into a windowed viewer of the HDMI capture. That way I can see what's happening on the screen of the device while also using my PC connection to be able to interact with it with ADB and Fastboot. Some people do this with a powered OTG adapter. That way you can actually plug a keyboard into the device. The guide that I'm going to get to here in a moment is you don't need to have a keyboard connected to it. You can do it all from your main PC just through the power being delivered on the micro USB and then monitor it with the HDMI capture. So let's go take a look at how to actually get this installed onto this on box. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. You can see on the screen the output from the Walmart box, the ONN or on or whatever they call it box. And I'm just going to go through the initial setup. And you see in the bottom right is my terminal output when we get to running ADB and Fastboot and all that stuff. So I'm just going to go through the actual setup, the first time setup out of the box with the device. Android TV no longer allows you to just skip logging in with your Google account during setup. So ideally, I would do just log into Wi-Fi and then hit skip and then go to the desktop because all we need to do is enable USB debugging. But Google requires you, or Android TV requires you, to log in with your Google account. It's way easier just to do it through your phone if you have an Android phone or the, I don't know if the Google app on iOS works, but it's just way easier to go through the actual setup on the device. That way you're logged into Wi-Fi and the Play Store. Otherwise you have to do it all through the remote on the device. Also, go ahead and let it do its update. As of December 3rd, 2021, running the update on the box does not stop you from being able to install the custom ROM. It will make you watch the whole thing. So here, we're just going to skip forward and let the restart happen after the update is finished downloading. And I'm going to speed this up a little bit. That way we can get through the whole system update. Go ahead and let it do this whole thing. The only thing not shown here is I did the controller update too. That'll come up on your first boot after you finish the update. None of it stops you from being able to flash the custom ROM. Here we are back at the first boot. I'm going to disable installing all those additional apps because we're trying to get rid of bloatware. Going to skip through all of the setup as much as possible, other than logging in with your Google account. Then, once it finally lands to the Android TV main screen, we're going to go to Settings, and then down to Device Preferences, About, and then all the way down to the bottom of the About section for the device, and tap on or click on Using the Remote Build 7 or 8 times. I forget how many times it is until you become a developer. Then go back and go down to Developer Options and enable USB debugging. Hit OK. And then hit allow for that your computer that is plugged into to be able to connect to it via USB. Now I'm going to use ADB, check, make sure that the device is connected, and then reboot it to the bootloader. The bootloader is just the screen for the ON or ONN device. So if we run fastboot devices, you'll see that we are connected. So now I'm going to unlock the bootloader. You're going to do that fastboot flashing unlock. It's really fast to do that. And then I'm going to flash the custom recovery, which you'll download with the unofficial Lineage OS build for this device. Obviously, be sure to get the right recovery for your device. This is for this they've codenamed Dopinder. And then I'm going to boot into that custom recovery. Now, this is where I ran into a couple of problems. After I flashed the custom recovery, I went to boot into it, it didn't happen. So it's clearly it didn't flash. So I had to do a power cord pull and wait for it to reboot all the way in and then use ADB to reboot back into the bootloader. And then attempt to boot into the custom recovery that should have been flashed. So once we get back to the bootloader, I'm going to check to make sure that fastboot is connected to the device. And then boot into the custom recovery. And after it thinks about it for a few minutes, we now get to the custom recovery. You see it's got the LineageOS branding at the very top. This is very different than the stock recovery. So the next step is to reboot into sideload mode because I don't have a keyboard connected. So we need to use ADB to reboot into sideload mode. That way I can flash the custom ROM. After we've done the recovery, now we'll do the ROM. After it processes and comes up, you can see it didn't actually boot into the custom recovery. It's already in sideload mode, but it's in the stock recovery. So when I flash the LineageOS build, it's going to fail. And you'll see here, we'll just skip forward a little bit, and you can see that it will fail. So then using the button on the box, I will long click the button on the side of the box to select reboot system. Now we'll speed things up a little bit, go back into Android TV, and then use ADB to reboot back into the bootloader. Then when I'm back in the bootloader, I will flash the recovery again and then boot into the custom recovery again. It took me 3 times flashing the custom recovery for it to finally stick and allow me to boot into it and get into the custom recovery for sideloading. Once it reboots into the recovery, then we'll do ADB sideload, reboot into sideload mode, And once it processes that, thinks about it for a couple seconds, still processing. And now you can see it's in the custom recovery and in sideload mode because I don't have a keyboard connected, so I'll do it all through ADB. Now I'll do ADB sideload and the custom ROM to start the flashing process. It will transfer it and do the install. We speed up here a little bit. And then after it's done, because I don't have a keyboard set, a connected device, I'll do ADB reboot back into the bootloader. Now the bootloader looks different. It's just this Android TV instead of the ONN branding. You'll see I'll check to make sure that the fastboot is connected. And then run the wipe, because I don't have a keyboard, so I can't navigate through the custom recovery. So do fastboot tack W to do the cache wipe. And then finally do a fastboot reboot. And speed this up a little bit so you can see now we have LineageOS installed. No more ONN branding. The controller section that they showed there, it's not that keyboard shortcut. So remember from the very beginning, it's back and home, not the two buttons that they show. And you can see there at the very end that I have de-bloated the operating system. So I would say it took me about a half hour after I did it one time through, which took me a couple hours to make sure that I got everything right, to be able to go back through and do this guide. So, I mean, I'm not a developer, so it probably might take you an hour, maybe a half hour, maybe shorter to be able to do this. But it took me, after I'd been through it once and I did it again, about a half hour to do it. You can flash it back to stock. There's a note in the description below too, where you could go download those files and then just run the script and flash it like you would a Pixel device to flash it back to stock. The directions do say that it can't lock it again, but if you just want to put it back to whatever it came with out of the box, you can do that. In my experience so far using it is that it has been really, really nice to de-bloat the apps, the pre-installed apps that come on the device, which is also a lot better than what my smart TV has, which has a ton of stuff that I cannot remove. This just has YouTube Music, and one other app plus the Play Store. The Play Store is baked into the ROM. You just flash the recovery and the ROM and away you go and booted right up. I'm also going to be experimenting with some other apps like S-Tube Next to be able to have a better YouTube experience, which is really what I'm after.